Before we get started, I'm going to show you which materials you'll need to use for this project. You will need 5 straws. It's okay if they're the bendy type of straws, that's totally fine. If you can fit more than 5 straws in your hand when you're making this project, which you'll see why later, you can actually do more and make the thickness bigger, but you can use just 5 straws to start out with your first project. You'll need a bead reamer. This tool comes in handy for a lot of things. It's really sharp at the tip, and I'll show you why later. But a bead reamer, it's easy to find these at Michael's or someplace like that. You'll need an X-Acto knife, and be very careful with this, super sharp at the tip. You don't want to hurt yourself. And a pair of scissors. You'll need some piece of cardboard. I got this off the back of a notebook, but it's so that you can use your X-Acto knife, so you'll want this every time you use an X-Acto knife. And then you'll need some colorful yarn. Ooh, colors. You'll need whatever color you want to use. The fluffier yarn actually makes these look a lot better, so if you want to use something fluffy, I'm actually going to use this assortment of colors today. So your first step is going to be get out your 5 straws and make sure that you have them on a piece of cardboard. Open up your X-Acto knife and you're going to take each straw, and if you have the bendy straws, you're going to use the opposite end, and you are going to lay it down and cut a slit in the bottom of the straw. Make sure that your slit is about this long and make sure that the ending is still intact. So make sure it's all together. And then you're just going to flip it over and you will put another slit in the same exact spot on the other side of the straw. So it'll be a straw and it'll have 2 holes on either side. This is a super important step, so make sure you keep the bottom intact. And you'll just keep doing that over and over again. Next step is to take your yarn and cut off a piece of it. That is about arm span length across. Now, if you're going to make a scarf, you're gonna make it much longer than that, but it's going to be arm span length across for the ear warmer. So if you wanna do it a little bit longer too, so you have frillies at the end of the ear warmer, you can do that as well. Next, you will take your yarn and you're going to fold it in half. Make sure that it's even. And you're going to take your bead reamer tool. This is not used for this, but it makes it much easier, and you'll use this for other projects as well if you plan on making a beaded bracelet. And you're just going to twist the loop around the bead reamer tool, just like that. You're going to take one of your straws, and at the end of it, you're going to put it through the holes that you made. And you're just gonna pull through one side, take out the bead reamer tool, and then make sure it's the same length towards the bottom. So it's going to look like this. You're going to do this 4 more times so that you have all 5 of your straws with the string through them. Now that you've got all 5 straws with the string through them, it's going to look like this. So you see each one has the string through them. And you're going to put 4 of them down, take your last one, take your roll of yarn and pull out some of the string. And then just simply tie a knot around the bottom of one of your straws. So just like that. You can do a double knot too if you want to. So it's going to look like that. And then you can cut this piece off. So it'll look like this. You're going to put your strings back together. Make sure you leave this one to the side. And you're going to tie the bottom of these just so that it stays together the whole time. So you're going to tie the bottom. Now you're going to take the string that's on the roll of yarn and you're going to do a wrapping technique. It's hard at first to keep the straw still and in your hand in the same spot, but you'll get a hang of it and you'll find your own way to make this easy. So what you're going to do is you're going to wrap it over and under between the straws so that it makes this kind of pattern. And then you're going to come back around and do the same thing. And you're just going to do this over and over until you get a bunch of it on the straws. I will usually go all the way up until the bendy part of the straw, until about that much is left on the straw, just because it's easier to hold if you have some of it on there. So you can start pushing it down together, and as you can see, it starts to look kind of like a scarf. So you just keep doing this pattern over and over. Until you get enough on here. Now that you have quite a bit of yarn on your straws, it's so much easier to hold, as you can see. It's way easier. And make sure you've just been pressing them down together. Make it close and knit. And also make sure you haven't cut off any yarn from this. If your infinite supply of yarn for your scarf or your ear warmer is going to come from this. So now that we have quite a bit on there, all you're going to do is keep pressing it down. So you're going to keep pressing it down onto the strings that are hanging. And now it's a little bit harder to hold the straws, but if you want, you can keep some of this still on here. And then just keep going and keep pressing it down as you go. And eventually it's gonna get to the bottom and turn into the ear warmer or the scarf. So when you get to the end, you're going to snip off all of your straws. You can just snip the yarn right off of them and it's going to end up with all of the frayed edges of the yarn. And you're just going to simply take the end of your scarf or your ear warmer and you're going to put it into a knot. And then if you have the fluffy yarn like I do, you can make it all frilly at the end. So it's gonna end up looking like this. So it's gonna be really pretty. And then you can just simply put it on as your ear warmer, or you can wear it as a scarf. And this is a great gift for your family or friends. I hope you enjoyed the craft we made today. If you love crafting as much as we do, make sure you check out all of our Choose Friendship products. And to enter to win the ultimate craft prize valued over $300, just follow this link below. We wish you a very happy holiday season and always choose friendship.